older than God. It is sound with no listener, sight with no seer. Life, but no one living it. In silence, I am nothing. I am everything. I am silence.
Hiking up at Big Sur today. It is beautiful and empty and silent, just how I like it. I've kind of been bouncing this idea around for a few months. I don't like having to follow all the YouTube rules. You gotta have candid content. It's gotta be this, it's gotta be that. Tell people to subscribe, da 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 da. I'm not into all that stuff. I'm passionate about two things, okay? One, filmmaking. I love putting together sick edits with music I love, filming at gorgeous locations like this. And two, I love talking about consciousness. It's my favorite thing. And so this idea I had was something that I think would be highly beneficial for the world, but it's something that's kind of unprecedented, that's never been done before. Ever since August of 2017, a little over a year now, I've been on this journey of my consciousness expanding rapidly. And it's felt like it's beginning to accelerate over the last 3 months and at an even greater pace. And the things that have been happening to me are blowing my own mind, quite literally. It's been a remarkable journey. And I just decided a few months ago, like, I don't want to forget about all this. It's easy to forget the little steps along the way. And it's been a wild ride. And I feel like it's something that the world could benefit from, because nobody's ever documented their spiritual awakening on video as it's happening. And I think it's important for somebody to start doing that, because there are things that are happening to my consciousness that are completely outside of my control. Something is being done to me and I can't stop it or slow it down. But it's only happening because I desired it to happen. And every step of the way continues to surprise me. There's things I want to share with the world that are happening to my consciousness that are truly remarkable. And I want to create a space for other people who are going through this same awakening to have somebody to relate to have another experience to weigh against their own and see, wow, other people are experiencing the same things that I'm experiencing. And I would love to be a facilitator for that, to create a community of people who can share their own journeys and accelerate our growth even faster, because our planet's on a time crunch, guys. The only way our species is going to be saved is if we wake up. And this spiritual awakening is happening on the planet right now. And I want to be a facilitator for that. So I'm going to start posting vlogs about my own awakening, the realizations I'm having, the inner workings of my psychology that are changing. Because who I am right now is completely unrecognizable to me from the Aaron that I knew even a year and a half ago. I don't even recognize that person anymore. I don't know where he went, but something has happened that has erased him from existence. I still have many of the same personality traits, of course, but anything that had to do with ego in any way is slowly being chewed apart by this force that's moving inside of me. I had this idea about 3 or 4 months ago, and I sort of cast it aside because my mind said, well, people are gonna judge you, man. They're gonna think your awakening is fake because you're trying to get attention or something like that. And I had a little bit more ego back then, so I listened to the voice in my head and I kind of shucked it off. And then about 2 weeks ago, the idea came back with even more force. And it was pretty obvious to me that this was something the universe was presenting to me. This was something that the universe wants to be born, and it wants me to do it. So I'm just gonna follow that intuition, and I'm gonna start posting vlogs every week about my own journey. And hopefully my experience can help other people who are also awakening to accelerate even faster. Because I haven't been able to find anybody else really who's going through the same experience as I am. So I'm just gonna put myself out there. If you're out there and you wanna talk and you wanna share in this journey together, let's go. So this is awakening vlog entry number one. I've been on this awakening journey for about 14 or 15 months now, but there's something that's been happening very recently that I really want to share with people. And it's been the most incredible development so far. And that is that the more silent that my being becomes, the more I am noticing that I am becoming like a mirror to people. It's kind of difficult to explain. It started out very subtle, but the mirroring has become more and more intense as of late, to the point where I could not deny that this process is really playing out in my life now. And I'm really just astounded at it, to be honest with you, because this is something that in spirituality is often called mirroring consciousness. And this is what is always said of the great like Indian sages, the great Buddhist sages who, holy men, who are these amazingly enlightened gurus, that when people are around them, what they always say about them is that they are like a perfect mirror, meaning that any egoic behavior in their presence is immediately called to attention. The reaction that the guru has to the student shows the student right away, oh wow, that was a fear-based thought, or that was an egoic-based thought. And this process is completely effortless on the part of the guru, completely effortless on the part of the sage. It is just a natural response to the ego. So these sages become so sharp and so laser-like in their precision at seeing the ego, even the most subtle movements of the ego. These sages can spot it right away. And it's not even that they can spot it. It's like it's being spotted by awareness itself. People often poo-poo on spiritual seekers who, you know, kind of kiss the feet of the guru and they kind of almost worship the guru. But if you experienced what they are, you would understand why, because they are being set free at such a rapid pace that it's almost as if, you know, they're in the presence of God himself. And any impurity, any contaminants in their consciousness is being burnt out. And that's because the guru has no personal identity any longer. The guru's consciousness is completely empty. It is completely silent. And the silence is the reason why the guru becomes this perfect mirror to anyone that he interacts with, he or she interacts with. Because it's like the surface of a lake. You can only see your reflection in a lake if there are no ripples in the water, if there is no mind activity getting in the way. There's just a perfect reflection. I read a book about the famous Indian sage who died in the late 70s, Neem Karoli Baba, who Ram Dass made famous. And I learned about this concept of a mirror in consciousness by reading that book. And it's only because I read that book that I started to catch on that this process is happening in me. And the way that this process started for me was that I started to feel this movement inside of myself whenever I would be around somebody who was having a moment in ego, whether it was just a comment they said or whether someone's arrogance was just kind of popping out through the conversation we were having. Because I had become so disinterested in my own ego and so nauseated by my own ego, I would find the same reaction happening to other people's egos. And it's not a judgmental thing at all. It's just this recognition of truth, that the way this person is behaving is not the truth. And the movement that would happen is that I would sort of, it's really not something I can explain, but the best way I can put it is that I sort of retreat into silence. I just become empty. And it's almost like a way of protecting my vibration, I think. It's like the natural essence of me feels the ego energy that they're putting off and meets it with equal force. But not with the same force, with the opposite force. So if they act out of anger, I respond by sinking into peace. I feel and become more peaceful. And it just happens. It's not something I work up or do with any effort. It's just a reaction to their behavior. And if someone is sad or suffering, I have this outpouring of love and compassion that again just arises by itself. And it started to become more and more obvious, to the point where I couldn't deny any longer that this was happening. And then the next step that happened was that my actual response to them would change. And this has always been something I haven't been good at as a person, is that I always placate to people's egos. If somebody wants validation, I give it to them. If somebody wants to play the victim card, I validate them. Oh, you poor thing, you're right, that's such a hard situation. Oh, you must have really been upset. Oh, boo-hoo, poor you. And that's so natural to who I was as a person, but now I have the exact opposite reaction. And I started to notice it when I saw it in other people's eyes, where they would say something like, oh, I'm gonna complain about this situation. I want you to feel bad for me. The ego is looking to be validated by you feeling bad for me. And when I would look at them with this look of like, I'm not going to pity you for that. I'm not going to stroke your ego and validate your victim card you're playing. But at the same time, they know that it's coming from a loving place. Like they can sense that I care about them deeply. I'm just not placating them right now. Little movements of my ego that are so subtle that I could have never caught them by my own effort. But all of a sudden I'm in the middle of a conversation or an experience or something. Some thought rolls by or I hear myself say something and awareness makes known to me, very politely, I might add, this thing you just said, that's where the ego is hiding in that statement. This statement, this is a ego conditioning pattern. And as those of you who are going through your own spiritual awakening know, every time you notice the ego doing something, it starts to dissolve it. Because the ego can only be an unconscious movement, right? The second you're aware of what the ego's doing, it's burnt up. And it takes some time usually, but not always. Sometimes it's like one and done. So as this would happen for me, my clarity has become so accurate, so laser-like in its precision that every little comment people make, almost word for word, I can detect where ego is hiding in their statement, where insecurity, jealousy, anger, bitterness, resentment, pride, any of those things are hiding. It's just completely obvious to me. But it's remarkable to me that I am not doing mirroring. I'm just becoming a mirror. Does that make sense? It's a force moving within me that I can't stop. I don't even have a say in it. It is taking zero effort on my part to be so laser-like. It is a completely effortless action. It's not even an action. I don't even feel like I'm doing anything. And it is effortless because it is the most natural thing. It is the earliest intelligence. It is the intelligence that existed before the mind existed. It is the intelligence that even allows the mind to exist. There is just this silence, this emptiness inside of my being that is so still and so perfect and so clear, and it mirrors everything it comes in contact with. So try to hang with me here. This is what's really remarkable. I can tell you to throw everything away. Just do this exercise with me for 1 second, okay? I can say, all right, just for a minute, just be still, be silent. Don't hold on to anything. Do not hold on to any idea, any thought, any desire, any memory, any story, any identity, any attachment. Throw everything away. Just for a moment, get rid of everything. Just be here in this moment without anything. And you know, most people are able to do this for at least, you know, 10 to 15 seconds and the mind jumps back in. But when you achieve this state of emptiness where you've thrown everything away, what is left that cannot be thrown away? What remains that cannot be gotten rid of? That was the question I started to ask myself. And the answer was two things. The first is myself. I cannot throw myself away. I am always here. The second one was silence, because when I have this silent state of being, there is still something there, and it's the silence itself. And the silence can't be gotten rid of. The silence can't be removed. I can add things on top of silence, but I cannot get rid of the silence. And so the next obvious question I started asking was, is the silence and myself two different things? And it has become increasingly obvious that the answer is no. They cannot be two different things. Oh, this looks like a nice place to sit and chill for a minute. Oh, my legs are killing me. And so this silence that cannot be removed, I've started to be able to separate myself, my sense of self, apart from it, less and less. Meaning that I have felt my identity shifting into it, in the sense that when I even hear the word emptiness, silence, which aren't ultimately what it is, of course, but when I think about these concepts, the same reaction internally happens in me that used to happen when I would hear someone say my name. And now when I hear someone say my name, the reaction I have is not that same energy anymore. It's sort of a, oh, that's what people call me. And another thing that started to happen was that I had this increasing urge to meditate all the time, just because getting into that stillness just felt so good. The closest thing I can describe to it is like the feeling you have like after hiking for 5 hours and you're covered in dirt and sweat and just disgusting, and you get into a nice warm shower and wash all that dirt off and soap up and towel off and you're perfectly clean again. That's sort of the feeling that it gave me. So I would crave meditating all the time. And I started to realize that I crave this silence so much because I am that silence. I cannot separate my identity from it any longer. And the more that I am recognizing silence as my true nature, the more and more I am becoming this mirror, because whatever gets put into silence only comes out as origination, because silence is the origination of the universe. Before there was anything, there was silence. Everything is born out of silence. And when I say silence, I don't mean no noise. I mean silence of being, meaning there's no clouds, there's nothing blocking the clarity, the intelligence from shining. I need to hurry up and get back, it's getting late. But so if silence is the most original thing, then I must be that, right? How could I be anything different from it? And the coolest thing about it is that this is like direct evidence of the phrase that I always talk about, which is, you are the universe experiencing itself. We all know law of attraction. The first rule is that the universe is a mirror that is mirroring you, mirroring your state of consciousness. And all of a sudden I find myself becoming a mirror to others. Naturally, spontaneously, without effort. And that's because I am the universe experiencing itself. And it's one thing to know that intellectually, but it's an entirely different thing to have that be your experiential reality. And that's what enlightenment will do for you. Enlightenment will show you as an experience, not a thought or an idea, that you are inseparably one from all that there is. And I often hear people on YouTube who are going through this journey as well say that it's almost scary to them because it feels as though something is being done to them. And I can totally sympathize with this because at times I also feel like something is being done to me. But at the same time, I immediately recognize it as me. And so there's no fear there. There's no one even to be afraid because it is chewing my ego up. And it's the mind that gets scared because it's on a death count. Whatever is seen by awareness gets put on a death count. It has a ticking clock now. And this process can seem scary to some people going through it. And if that's where you're at, then I encourage you to take heart and step into the fire, because this fire will purify everything that is not you. This fire will burn up everything that isn't you. And that which steps out of the fire, that which remains, that which cannot be burnt away, is what you are. Is the real you. And in the place of all the things that were burnt away is the most incredible peace, the most incredible bliss and innocence. And it's not even accurate to say replaced, because the only reason that these things are there is because they were always there, but they were just covered up by all the bullshit, by all the ego games and nonsense that we are so entertained by and give so much identity and significance to. So these things that are natural to our basic essence cannot shine through. And when you come to this place, whether that's just in a nice meditation session or whether you become permanently awake, the question I have for you is, in this place of emptiness, when everything has been thrown away, what remains? And you say, just this silence. And I say, can it be other than you? Because who is there in the emptiness? Who is there in the silence? You are there, right? So how can you be separate? You are silence itself, and everything else comes after. But silence is the origination. You are the silence of the universe. And that's something that's been a really cool new development for me. All right, time to get going.